Hi there folks, and welcome to my channel. I'm gonna show you today how to make good Greek spinach pie. First off, we're gonna need a couple of bunches of spinach. Usually they're about 1 pound each. And we're gonna need green onions, one or two bunches chopped rather thinly, a couple of eggs. We're gonna need also dill wood, chopped rather thinly, and feta cheese, a good chunk of feta cheese, and salt and pepper and olive oil, and 1 box phyllo dough. Now we're gonna cut the spinach rather coarsely because we're gonna squeeze it a little bit afterwards to wilt it. I don't like blanching because it turns spinach to mush. You don't want to have like creamed spinach in your spinach pie. You want to feel the texture of the vegetables. So we're gonna chop up the spinach and then put it in a colander because we need to give it a good squeeze, kind of punch it down in the colander until some of the water comes out and the spinach is a little bit wilted. Okay, now that spinach is wilted, we discard about 1 cup of juice that came out and put the spinach back in the pot along with the onions, the dill, and the feta cheese, a little sprinkling of pepper, and I'm gonna add a couple of eggs, slightly beaten. The eggs will act as a glue and hold the pie together. All right, and then we mix it up real good so everything, all the ingredients are very well incorporated. And now it's time to lay the dough to the pan so we get our pie ready. Here is the phyllo dough that I bought. Usually I buy a bigger size, but that's what I found today and that's what I bought. They're sort of kind of like smaller than usual, so I'm gonna just use a smaller pan instead. I know that my method is a little unorthodox. I don't use a brush to oil the leaves. I just use my hands. I dip my hands in oil and then touch the leaves here and there, and you know, that kind of oils them. They stick on your hands and then you lift them and you put them in the pan. You can use your brush, but I find this is more time efficient, this method. It just goes faster and the leaves don't break that much. So after we put 6 or 7 leaves at the bottom, we put a generous amount of the spinach mixture, and don't skimp on that. You gotta have some spinach in a spinach pie. And then we're gonna just keep on putting leaves on top, another 6 or 7 maybe, or 10 or 15, whatever you want. The crunchier you want it, the more leaves you put. I put just enough for my taste, and then if I have extras, I make something else with it. Okay, now we have enough leaves on top. And all this overhang, I'm gonna just turn it inside and roll it in like this. And we're gonna need to put a little bit of oil there. Oil it so it's kind of, you know, it will be crunchy, but it's not gonna dry out and fly off. Okay. And now we're gonna cut it. Take the knife and cut it, but not all the way to the bottom. Cut it just enough. The top leaves have to be cut because you cannot cut them after they're cooked. They're too crunchy. So we cut them before we bake. Okay, that's done and ready to bake, but I have some phyllo dough leaves left over, so I'm gonna just oil and fold a couple and show you a different way to wrap them, spinach pies. All right, you go like this. You put a bunch of filling at one end and you lift one corner and make a triangle, and back and forth. You just squeeze it in there. If it doesn't want to stay, it will stay. Four layers of Phyllo will not rip, so you can just, you know, be a little rough with it. All right, then you oil another, fold it in half, and go the same way. There you go. These are crunchier, and it's pocket food, is the kind of stuff that you take for lunch with you at work. They're very good too. Okay, we're done with that and ready to put them in the oven. The oven is preheated at 380 degrees. You bake them anywhere from 370 to 385 or so. The hotter the oven, the crunchier they are on the outside. I made two pies and a few of these little ones with the two bunches of spinach. And okay, 380 for the oven. In they go for about maybe 30 to 45 minutes. It depends on your oven, how hot it is. Varies. I'm gonna switch places, the tops from the bottom and the bottom at the top. About midway, and here we are ready, about 35-40 minutes past. They're good and ready, and it's time to try it. Here's one of the square pieces and one of the triangles. The triangles are a little crunchier, but both, they're really, really, really good. Yum. Very good. These are very good.